Well, hey, folks, welcome to the More Summer 2020 Adventures Day 41. And it is August the 5th, August the 5th, 2020. And I hope y'all had a good day because we did. As far as going anywhere, doing anything outside the campground, that was not a, nope, didn't do none of that. The wife was busy all day, catching up on laundry and things here in the RV. This morning when we finally got up, we had to wait for the people in our site now to depart before we could change from the one that we had last night into this one, which is where we'll be for the next, the next five nights, counting tonight. So I guess the next four nights. That was really, about it. Earlier on, later in the afternoon, early in the evening, we went over to that, the national, shopping Mecca, you know what I'm talking about, and, did a little bit of things over there. Got some needed items and, came on back, and then, the wife, grilled some bratwurst outside, and, we just kind of kicked back and relaxed a little bit. So, not a whole lot today. This video will probably be very short. I worked on my journal. I got caught up on it. I was about 3 days behind. But got it taken care of. And, even though I'm doing the videos each night, I'm also, trying to write a journal of each of our daily happenings and, things of that nature. So, worked on that while she did laundry and got the camp set up. There's only like about four pictures that I'll be posting tonight, and that's just of the RV and our new site with our awning out, the flags up, the yard pennants up. Not really a whole lot of things going on today. Tomorrow we plan on getting up. I wasn't gonna really do anything tomorrow, and then the wife and I talked about it. We do want to go to Crater Lake, so I think tomorrow, being Thursday, would be the better day to do it rather than waiting until Friday or Saturday when the weekend traffic is up there. I realize it's summer, okay, and there's going to be some traffic, but my thinking is, if we do it tomorrow, we won't have to deal with a lot of tourists such as ourselves, so. We may get up a little earlier than what we had initially planned, so we can get on the road and get over there. It's about an hour and a half, maybe 2 hours, over there. And so it's going to be a 4-hour trip, that way, not counting the time that we spend there. So, and then we can not have to deal with the traffic and all that on, Friday or Saturday. So, but all of that being said, is really just a very relaxed day. I didn't do a whole lot. Mama worked, she did the laundry. Okay. So, that being said, going to be a kickback day. Not sure what we're going to do after tomorrow, but, we'll play it by ear. That was one of the reasons for spending 4 or 5 days here was just so we could relax and not have to be rushed. Why try to get someplace and do something when you're beat for time and you can't really enjoy what's going on? Okay, so, and speaking of enjoy, I've gotten some comments, and thank you. I appreciate your comments that you are enjoying the videos. It's just a some way of sharing our adventures and our trip with you all. Try to give you some pictures of what we're going through, what we're seeing. So, bratwurst, full tummy. Time to go to sleep. Take a nap. We'll go to sleep for a night. There ain't no nap. Go to sleep. I really do. The video, the comments you're making about the video. I'm glad you're enjoying them, and we hope to keep it going. Okay. speaking of keeping it going, let's keep it going with the scripture. Today's is James 1:13. Let no one say when he is tempted, I'm tempted by God. For God cannot be tempted by evil, nor does he himself tempt anyone. And the short version says, when tempted, no one should say, God is tempting me. For God cannot be tempted by evil, nor does he tempt anyone. Like I say, that's James 1:13. You know, there's a lot of discussion out there, and it's not about whether God can tempt us or not. No, that's scripture. He will not tempt us, all right? But, you know, as a believer, you know, Satan is going to want to tempt us with things that we know or we conceive as sins, all right? And put doubt in it. I mean, even tempting us with doubt. You know, does God really care? Does God really love me? Well, let me tell you what. Yes, he does really love you. And yes, he does care. If he can pick me, okay, with all my faults and all my sins and all the things that I've done wrong and say, I still love you, Jerry, and my son died for you, then I know that he is real, okay? And I know that his word is real. You don't have to believe me. Try it yourself, okay? All right? You know, I am my own testimony. I know where I came from. I have a very good pastor friend, you know, that's, you know, beat up from the street up and knocked down from the floor down, you know, or something like that. Pastor Spear, you know what I'm talking about. And those of you that know Pastor Spear know what he's saying. Okay. God's not going to tempt you. Satan's going to tempt you to try to get doubt in your mind and say, look, yeah, you failed him now. You know, look what you did. You think really God's going to forgive you for that now when you were supposed to be a Christian and you did this and you did that? You know, he's going to tempt you with all that sort of stuff. He's going to tempt you for, you know, doing other things, whatever they may be, that you know is wrong. And then he's going to come back and say, look what you did. And you call yourself a Christian. You ain't nothing but a heathen. You ain't nothing but a sinner. Well, you know what? I was a heathen, and I was a sinner, and I'm still a sinner. I ask God every day for forgiveness, and I thank him for his son and his saving grace. You know, by his stripes we are healed, and by his blood we are saved. All right? So, you know, in fact, in some ways, be glad you're being tempted, because that means you can call closer. You can call on God and walk closer to him, because the closer you walk to him, the more temptations you're going to have. If you're just a so-so Christian, just a so-so lukewarm with your relationship, Satan ain't going to be worrying a whole lot about you. But you get close. You get close to that hem of that garment, and you get close to a father with a daily walk with your Heavenly Father, and Satan is going to be on you like stink on doo-doo. And you can take that to the bank, Frank. Okay? Hey, that's my sermon for today. Y'all be blessed. We hope to come with you tomorrow. Where I say tomorrow we're going to go to Crater Lake. So hopefully there'll be some pictures of the Crater Lake. I was there years ago, like in the 68 maybe. And my wife was there even... before that, I think. Maybe not, but, you know, it's been a long time since either one of us have been there. We've never been there together, so we are definitely looking forward to tomorrow's trip. Y'all be blessed. God bless you. We'll see you tomorrow.